Hi, welcome to another video on annotations, and my name is Jayaraj. So in here, we will discuss types of annotations in Java. So let's get started. In Java, we have two types of annotations, standard annotations and custom annotations. And the standard annotation is also known as built-in or predefined annotations, and custom annotations also known as user-defined annotations. So standard annotations are defined and provided by Java, and Java APIs contains them. And it has superclass of annotation class, which is inside lang.annotation package. And further in this, we have 8 annotations of 2 different categories, which are general purpose annotations and meta annotations, which is annotations about annotations. And in general purpose, we have 4 annotations, which is override, suppress warning, deprecated, and functional interface. And this functional interface is introduced in Java 8. And in meta annotation category, we have 4 annotations, which is documented, inherited, target, and retention. And one more thing to note here is that this general purpose annotations are in java.lang package, and meta annotations are in java.lang.annotations package. Next, we have custom annotation or user defined annotations, and we can create our own custom annotations and provide additional functionality based on our requirement to the code. And these annotations are created using predefined annotations. So for example, this test annotations is created using document and retention, which is predefined or standard annotations. We will discuss this how to create custom annotations and how to use them in detail in upcoming videos. Additionally, based on number of annotation members, we have 3 categories of annotations. First one is marker annotation. And in this annotation, we don't have any values or members, and it is like marker interface, and the compiler just need its presence. So for example, this @override annotation is in marker annotations. Once you put this annotation on top of any method, compiler get to know that this particular method is the overridden method. Second we have is a single valued annotations, and this annotations contains one member. For example, consider this suppress warning annotations, which has value equal to uncheck. And here, if annotations have only one member, you can omit the name of the member. So you can use this suppress warning as something like this. You don't need to provide value equal to uncheck. You can just directly provide uncheck. And next we have is multi-valued annotations, and these annotations have more than one members, and it is mandatory to mention names of all members at the time of using it. So for example, consider this web servlet annotations, which has name equal to abc.servlet and URL pattern equal to /abc.html. And these are the 3 categories of annotations based on the number of members that it has. So that's all for now in this tutorial, and see you in next one. Thank you very much.